Viral videos and memes are getting me through. I'm Dr. Erin, an Australian GP, and like you all, at the moment, I really need a good laugh to get me through this pandemic.
Oh, this is so good.
People are getting super confused about all the different messages coming left, right and centre. So I'm here to separate the fact from the fiction.
Look, you're washing your hands.
Oh. Get that coronavirus off of you.
All right, let's go.
Coronavirus!
It's just incredible how quickly our lives have changed.
Coronavirus!
Yep, me when anyone tries to touch me. Coronavirus!
Coronavirus!
Oh, I remember hugging people and giving people handshakes and hanging out in crowds. And now I balk every time anyone comes within 1.5 metres of me.
Is the important thing to remember, do not touch your face.
Okay, oh my goodness, don't touch your face. I just nearly touched my face then. If you've got the virus on your hands and then you're touching your face, well, that's the way it enters. Eyes, nose, mouth. And next minute, you're infected.
How is this so hard?
On average, we are touching our faces approximately once every 2.5 minutes. Up to 23 times per hour. Well, I just realized from doing all this that before I was like doing this, like just probably making sure I wasn't shiny, but I was like, stop touching your face. You're not supposed to. We're in a pandemic. Okay, oh, who do we have here? We've got ScoMo talking about not touching your face. Treasurer Josh Frydenberg in the background, touching the schnoz. There's a chin rub, there's lip touching. Oh, Josh, actually, why do we feel that touching our face is okay? Well, according to research, touching or skin-to-skin contact actually releases a feel-good hormone called oxytocin, which relieves stress and anxiety and makes us feel more calm. So it's no wonder we're touching our face 1,000 times per minute in a pandemic. Ugh. All right, yes, washing the hands. This is get anyone excited about washing their hands. Washing your hands is one of the most simple public health measures we can take right now. Do you know, somewhere I read the other day that only 19% of people wash their hands after going to the toilet globally. What? Actually, what I wanted to say there was drop the F bomb, which is that why I stopped. That's how disgusted I am. All right, let's see what's next. We will wonder if it will ever end. Is that the hand washing? Ah, da, 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 da. Never ends your story. Ah!
Hope you're washing your hands.
I'm always washing my hands. Should you be at the White House?
Donald Trump's face with a Snapchat filter over the top is hilarious. And disturbing. Okay, this is all filling me with anxiety about hand washing. And I think that's what's going on, is we have such a huge saturation of different public health messages telling us to do things. But I cannot stress enough, hand washing is so important. It's something that everybody can do. All it takes is soap and water. So soap, first of all, is extremely accessible, but also the coronavirus, which is a super sticky virus, is surrounded by a wall that's got these things called lipoproteins in them. And soap is made up of a really similar substance that breaks down those lipoproteins. So the soap draws the lipoprotein away from the wall of the virus, and that way the virus breaks up and is easily washed away by water. So all we need is soap and water. There's no exact science about how long we're supposed to do this for, but 20 seconds is the recommendation, because in 20 seconds, you can get to all the different nooks and crannies of your hands, and it's enough time to break down the virus. Okay, so let's see what we've got next.
Right. You, get out of your Sainsbury's uniform, get that coronavirus off of you, straight in the machine, don't touch anything.
I think that should probably happen anyway, pandemic or not. Yes. Oh! We're being drenched in dishwashing liquid. 20 seconds. Make sure you scrub her down for 20 seconds. That's definitely 20 seconds. That's excellent, team. Well done, everybody.
It's Corona time. Hey, it's Corona time right now.
Oh, we're panning to the dishwasher. Okay, it's fresh fruit in the dishwasher, time. Milk in the dishwasher. No need for dishwasher. Oh, the paper money. I mean, I can't remember the last time I actually handed over any cash. I mean, I think what's really happened is the downfall of cash. When are we ever going to see it again? So we get all these confusing advice about how long the virus lasts on different surfaces. It's super confusing, but all you need is good old household disinfectant. We just need to wipe down door handles, light switches, bench tops, and fresh fruit and veggies, just give them a wash with some water. Based on current research, we are far more likely to pick up COVID-19 from our interaction with other shoppers than from our shopping itself. Whoa, some people are taking personal protective gear to the max. Is that it? Oh my God. DIY masks that have been splattered all over the internet have been hilarious. Look, that's probably not helping anybody, but it's keeping everyone in a celebratory mood. I probably don't recommend this one at home, kids. We don't really want you suffocating during the pandemic. Everyone is just losing their marbles. Some kind of dragon. Got to get the GOT stuff in there. So what I love about these last clips is that it's kind of like going into battle against COVID-19, which I think is a great way to think about it. But the main message is keep it simple. Soap and water, some household disinfectant, and keep your distance. And don't touch your face. If you enjoyed this, hit subscribe.